out again. I think.
Are they?
I think.
Are they? Please don't be trolling me. I'd really like to see that Bastion Ember. Please pick it back.
Nope, it's gonna be a Hanzo coming out there.
Darn.
At the end of the day.
The stream, oh, sharp shot.
Yeah, Ember. Here's your desperate pleas right there. Switched back over the Bastion. Marty picking up the Orisa in on this push as well. Looks like Petticoat will be sticking on the D.Va for this push. And yeah, the stream experiencing a little bit of trouble there. Might have lost connection again, or so I see in the chat. That's okay. Looks like they might be considering a pause just to get everything back in working order before comps get picked up.
Is the stream having a bit of issue?
The stream is having a little bit of difficulty here, and it looks like there comes the pause.
You ready?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Alright, I'm gonna tell him to unpause. It's been having issues.
It's been having issues, but I see it back up now. It was
Camden says that it was having a bit of issues, so are we ready? All right, sorry for the technical difficulties of stream, guys. It's just been Wi-Fi's been being weird, and it's just always been a bit of it's just being a bit wonky this time of stream. So we're gonna be seeing goats from Odor Oxide, but with a May snotes.
That's what we like to call that in the business. That's Snotes. And here they come in on the charge immediately. Bulbul's getting booped right straight forward there. They're going to waste no time crashing onto the fight here. Honor Oxide knows where they want to take their fight. Ember trying to back up to a super position from which he can start putting in some damage. Petticoat frozen on point, but Sharpshot getting the early pick. Marty Barter falling into it as well. Things starting to slide in favor of TBA. Bird, the only member of the team really getting back in on the action. Bomsu was in that kill feed as well, but it's not enough. Sharpshot going on an absolute tear here with this Junkrat. Manages to get three, make it four at the end of all that. And good lord, he pretty much drove him out by himself right there.
It seems that Ember's going to reset up behind that rock instead of high ground like I was originally expecting them to set up. But I guess it's just going to how it's going to be and can't really change it, but you know.
Well, in all fairness, the rock right there is an infamously good point for Bastion as they come charging in again. Bulbul's going in for a charge there with grab, actually ended up in the wrap. Rock, that's not a particularly good place. Tyre comes in over the top, didn't find anyone. Fomsu and Bird getting in on the action, though. Bamboo Cactus and the Coalescence damage booster coming in on the other side. That might get burned down by this Coalescence. Transcendence coming out, bringing in the healing. Trying to keep the team together and alive on the point as Marty Barty finally gets another shield down. The Fomsu right up in his face, giving him no space. It just went unleashes the sound barrier right there. There's still a lot of red bodies here contesting the point. Petticoat jumping out from behind the Orisa shield, and they're just towing the line right here. Petticoat and Marty jumping in and off of this point, keeping it around. Xavier getting taken out of neck. Bulbul's back now, trying to create some space for the team, just swinging away with the hammer there, and a good charge will take Ember out of this fight. You see the Blizzard coming in, doesn't really get anybody. Yikes, almost caught up there in the air. One of the supports will have to jump back on as Wolf Jonak trying to live up to his name right there and get a good pick. Won't quite find anyone, and Yikes will go down as well, but somehow Petticoat gets the opportunity to reback. Support lives were not lost in vain. There's Bob and Chuck over the top, won't get anyone though. God only knows what that bell is made out of on Hanamura, but it survives the nuclear explosion there.
You see, that's what you call a cockroach uranium.
I'm not familiar with that expression.
Cockroach uranium is just a term that I've pretty much developed right now called, it's basically because cockroaches are immune to pretty much all nuclear fallout, and that's pretty much the new backstory that I just developed.
Well, that's more lore than we've gotten in Overwatch for the last like 6 months. So congratulations right there. Looks like they'll be thinking about making a push here on the high ground and give up on that idea. They're going to go straight to point underneath here. Meanwhile, up on the high ground, CBA trying to pump some damage here. The Bastion all coming out. Ember looking for a cheeky pick there. Disappoint going down to the tire early on. Transcendence Unleashed now too. Dropping down with a little bit of help, trying to keep Ember alive. It won't work. Hammer down coming out the other side. Bull of Bulls, a good hammer down there. Tries to push up on his opposite number in the Reinhardt and secure a kill. Won't find it. Famsu getting some action and Bird as well. Yikes, still up on the high ground, finally dropping down to the point. Good anti-nade there. Famsu in a little bit of danger. Bird, though, still alive here. Famsu finally going down, but at a disappoint coming back. Ember doing a great job on the Tracer, just holding things down here. Sharpshot back out on the Junkrat. Firing these grenades, just trying to clear it out. And finally, at the end of all that, it looks like Otter Oxide will fall back and regroup.
Ember's going to be swapping back over to the Hanzo. Oh, maybe? He's having issues deciding, and it seems like he's going to stay on the Hanzo. And yikes, getting halfway to that nano boost, and Marty 20% away from that big boy, big Shattern. Sharpshot's just also going to be playing that Junkrat, but you'd normally think that Ember would be playing it as the fight ensues.
Yeah, and they're back on the point here, and it... Oh, oh no.
Oh, you hate to see that.
I believe that's what you people in the business like to call a bit of a C9 right there.
Charlie Niner.
Charlie Niner, indeed. Unfortunately, pulled back off the point. It was so close there, they really did not have the space to spare. Here's Sharpshot going absolutely ham on the Junkrat. Collecting a ton of kills with some really savage plays. Sharpshot has been just spectacular in all of these matches. Really a standout DPS player. One of the best I think I've seen so far in Outlet.
What, Ember?
What, Ember? No, Sharpshot. Sharpshot has been great.
Sharpshot. He's been extremely good. He's been popping off, but he just hasn't been popping off hard enough if he wants to carry this game.
Well, that was the first map there I think we saw TBA, you know, look like they were struggling a little bit. They were kind of lost a little bit of their momentum coming into it. Why do you think that happened there, Alu?
They probably lost it because they probably weren't expecting the swaps that they did, and especially they might have been just playing roles that their team isn't comfortable with, but at the same time, we don't know what's going on behind their scenes or what's going in their comms.
Indeed. It does look like some substitutions will be made here in preparation for our next map. Hacker X Pro 21 will be coming in for Famsu. Pi Ninja also out as well. It's like the subs coming into our next map. I'm not sure. It looks like we're going to be seeing some King's Row action here. So a brief visit to the United Kingdom. And based on what we've seen from these two teams previously, Alu, what do you think we'll see here on King's Row?
Well, Odor Oxide just won with their 2-2-2 comp, so can't really tell what's going on with that. It might be just that their GOATS was a bit more consistent than their 2-2-2, or their GOATS was just a fluke, or they just don't believe in their GOATS. TBA is just, they're a bit soul-searching, and they think they're just trying to get comfortable with their spawn room, maybe. See, I don't really know what's going on, because the only thing that I can know what's going on is what's going behind Marty and Bola Bowles' head, because they're the one that I know what's going on, because, well, they're playing main tank, and that's really the only comfortable role I'm with.
Fair enough. How do you feel like that main tank matchup has been going here in general? Do you feel like one of them has kind of been emerging the victor in that?
Well, it's been kind of tied from what I've seen. Bola Bowles has been getting primal a lot faster than what Marty's been, but Marty has just been kind of a bit more dominant on that Reinhardt. That's all I've been able to tell and notice so far.
Indeed. Well, it'll be interesting to see what they trot out here on King's Row. I feel like King's Row perhaps allows for some relatively good variety and compositions. We were talking just earlier about the potential for running, what was it, the 4 DPS comp on the King's Row map. So maybe we'll see something interesting like that. Going into this map, of course, it is 2-1 in favor of TBA, Otter Oxide, picking up the last win, though, there with a rather convincing performance on Hanamura, frankly making it look easy on the attack, but nobody tell TBA, because they've been putting up one heck of a show here for us as well. Be interested to see what we have coming out here. Looks like we're just swapping spectators around, making sure everybody's on the right side. Nobody needs some unnecessary scouting going on for them here. But King's Row, always an interesting map. And I think we'll see maybe Sharpshot again picking. I kind of hope that we see Sharpshot again picking up the Widowmaker, maybe get Bird back on the hitscan as well. Both of them have been playing some very convincing hitscan tonight, Alu. At least that was my feeling on it.
Yeah, and now we're going to be getting ready to go into this, and hopefully we can figure out what's going on in their minds. And as long as they figure out what's going on, if there's anything internal going on, hopefully it gets rid of it. And all they need to do is just push out the bubbles within the water, and they'll be able to figure out if they're going to play the game.
Yeah, well, for what it's worth, neither of these teams will be entering in the quote-unquote 4-0 squad at the end of week one here in Owlet.
Looks like it's going to be a smaller 4-0 squad at the moment than
will be a smaller 4-0 squad indeed. Looks like some early sort of picks coming in here. Hacker Pro picking up the Somber, which seems somehow vaguely appropriate, does it not?
Yeah, it does seem pretty appropriate, not gonna lie. Because he's a hacker, man. He's a hacker pro. He's gonna play Somber and he's gonna win.
Bamboo Cactus sticking in the Moira. I think we saw some good sort of coalescent skills coming out of Bamboo Cactus on the last map. So it makes a lot of sense. And sure enough, there's Sharpshot. I'll be switching back over to the Widowmaker. That has been very impressive all night long. And Ember, of course, too, is doing a great job on Junkrat. And he'll be taking the Junkrat here. Bird back on the Widowmaker as well. So, an interesting matchup, Alu. Any thoughts as we get started here? The door's about to open.
It seems like they're going to be running a normal Somber comp with the Moira Lucio instead of the Lucio Ana, which you'd normally see with a Somber comp, but it's also running Rein D.Va instead of Rein Zarya, especially with this comp. It seems a bit lackluster unless they're going for the pack bomb combo.
Already moving in underneath the hotel, but two quick kills in favor of TBA there, and make it four, why not, on top of that. I guess one, technically, if you count the D.Va mech and D.Va as the same entity. That will be an immediate stop there. No hesitation on him breaking that push up, and a good anti-nade started all off by Gold Jonak as well. And on that initiation, you see Bird engaging that sniper. Do will emerge the victor over Sharpshot. Here comes the push again. See if you're leading the charge. Bullet Bull's not far behind him. Your face, though, right up in Bullet Bull's face. Trying to get a pick there. Can't quite find it. Marty Barger and the two Reinhardts now really engaging on the center of this point. Betty goes jumping in front, getting a little bit of damage there. Coalescence now across the point. A good anti, though, will prevent Bullet Bulls from getting healed. Bullet Bulls going in with the anti on. Gets brought down finally by Your Face. A Disappoint was trying to come back onto the point, though, won't get there. That tire finally finds a home. And it's not somewhere where Disappoint wanted it to be. Petticoat pushing up now with Marty Barter, and that will signal an end to that fight. Any changes you see needing to be made here, Alu, or is it pretty straightforward?
It seems like they're doing what they're doing. It's just Ember coming in with the big bombs, and it just seems like they're going to be trying this out until they manage to get some ults first, and
hammer
doesn't
down
seem like they can do anything else.
Hammerdown came in there. Cactus was caught by it. Didn't really get a good follow-up on it, though. Marty Barter with the Nano will basically counteract the Shatter that came out there. Xavier, though, getting two with the D.Va Bomb, so that's a potential opening for Otter Oxide. But Xavier is forced to run away almost immediately. Bird, uncontested on the high ground, looking for a pick. Can't quite find it. Has settled for just putting shots into Marty Barter's shield. And Xavier gets caught trying to flee up there on the high ground. Will be T-Mech. Bullet Bull's coming back out to the point now. Gets stunned and anti right away. A Disappoint moving up in behind. I think trying to push Marty forward. No real follow-up on that, though. Your Face making life incredibly difficult for Bullet Bulls, who's anti yet again. Bullet Bulls going into charge, though, will get Marty down. The shield tank's trading here. You hit the grab come out, it gets eaten. Will be no grab. Petticoat maybe wants that back. You see another good nano coming in, though. Xavier this time. Sound Barrier coming in just half a second too late. Will help protect the rest of the members of the team. Bird has switched positions now. Not hitting the shots, though, in order to put these team members down. Ember getting back in the kill feed. He finds Bird hiding up there on the high ground. Sharpshot was half a step behind him, chasing that kill down, and that will signal the end of this.
Yeah, seems like they were doing everything that they needed to. It's just that your face came in with the faster reactions on ults, and I think they might actually need to swap something up. Like with you just saw that Hacker Code just got one clipped by Sharpshot and Bambooed swapping over to Mercy, and I think it might just be not Xavier's fault, but like Xavier may not just be doing their job properly, or they're just not adapting properly like they want to.
And while you see Bird switched off of the Widowmaker over onto the Pharah here, he's getting a little bit of help there up in the air, trying to put some damage in. Ooh, it's a hammer down. We'll take me now. Almost, is they gonna follow up on that bullet? Bullets over on the hammer. Bamboo catches, drops in the middle of the point all by himself. Will get taken down the kill. Solid blue here. The tire going in at the last second. I don't even think that was necessary. Just bullet bulls desperately trying to get out, but Ember finds a home for it anyway. He manages to take Aegis a point down right there. And Alu, another solid defense from TDA.
Seems like they should probably start swapping over into that stall instead of this giant current mess of whatever they're doing at the moment, because it seems like they're just not being organized, and it's reminding me of that first point of Busan. This has just been a pretty standard fight, and it just cleaned it up.
Yeah, that kill feed there at the end, bluer than Democratic National Convention, signaling an end to that fight, and it will be a 0.0% captured. It's a lot of zeros on screen. A bit rough there, perhaps, for Otter Oxide, but they'll have a chance for their own defense. A tall order, definitely, Halu. What do you think they need to do in order to make that tall order a reality?
If they really want to have the best chance that they can, I think they might just need to run goats.
Their goats comp does seem to be something they're familiar with, but they're kind of missing some of the magic they had there on Hanamura. It's a bit shame to see it disappear. Do you think there's any particular reason why that's the case?
They might have just stopped focusing onto the game. They might have just started small talking and just lost all the momentum that they thought they had. But it seems like Hacker will be running that Bastion, and I like Hacker Pro more than I probably should, just because he's running Bastion, but oh well.
Big Bastion fan. That's good.
Oh yeah. Bastion was the character that got me into this game.
Oh, fair enough. There you go. He is a deadly robot with a giant machine gun on the back. What's there not to like, really? Seeing the setup here, looks like Sharpshot will be sticking to that Widowmaker off the petticoat, playing the D.Va still, Ember. So this double sniper coming out again. Meanwhile, as you said, Hacker on the Bastion and Bird picking up the Mei, with Bullet Bulls switching to Orisa. Is that the first time we've seen him play Orisa tonight?
Yep, it is. It's the first time that anyone's decided to swap to the Orisa comp. Actually, no, that's a lie. That's a
no,
big
we have
lie.
Seen one. Yeah,
Marty
we've seen
played
it.
I just realized what I was saying.
Marty, these two main tanks showing off their depth of garages here. Playing all the main tanks on tap tonight. Shadow Sharpshot up on the high ground looking for an early pick. Can't quite find anyone though. A little bit of confusion there on the push, whether they go in for Tell or not. They finally decide to go straight to point. They see what's waiting for them. Bird, though, going down early will force the res out of a disappoint right there at the start of this fight. Sharpshot almost completely uncontested up on the high ground, putting in damage. His shield goes down, and oh, it's two big picks from Gold Jonak, living up to the name there. Bowl of Bowls managed to get on the kill feed, but it's Ember with the double kill on top of that. And things not looking good here for Otter Oxide. A desperate situation if ever there was one. Ember getting another pick here. This Hanzo going absolutely nuts. Bowl of Bowls trying to toe the line on the point. Won't quite make it. Bamboo Cactus jumping back on, trying to keep this alive. A deep charge from downtown coming in doesn't find anyone. Xavier drops on his dragons to zone out, and Xavier gets there just a half a tick too late. So TBA picks up map number 3 and the match here on this Sunday night matchup.
Yep, I guess that'll be the end, and it's certainly been something. It's been fun commentating with you.
That's good. Well, I'm glad you've had a good time. Any final thoughts for the audience here on how you felt the game win? Anything interesting? Players maybe we should watch out for in coming weeks?
Certainly the people that were, you know, playing the Widowmaker, Bird and Sharpshooter, or Sharpshot to win, they were doing extremely well. And Ember and Pie Ninja, they were doing extremely well on their respective roles. And can't ever forget about the supports that carry every team.
Indeed. It was a great game all around. Fun to watch there. No, Otter Oxide will not be joining the 4-0 squad. They're picking up that one win on Haramura, but at the end of the day, it is TBA emerging with a 3-1 victory over Otter Oxide here on Sunday night. Alex, I've been Corbeck, joined by AluV2. Thank you so much for joining us there in the chat on Twitch. We hope you enjoyed the match. Plenty more great Overwatch action coming to you from Outlet. Lots to look forward to in week two as well. This is just a taster of what we're going to see from these teams. And there's great plays coming out there and a lot to be